Hallelujah. Praise God. It's a new morning. It's a day that God has given to us. Are we going to make a difference? Are we going to use the time God has given us to bring the gospel to the lost? And this morning, I really want to encourage you. Don't let the time just pass you by. Don't let the time, caught up to you. We really should be building the kingdom of God. We should really, in the marketplace, wherever we are, we should build the kingdom of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amanda, goeiemôre, goeiemôre. Ek weet ook, jy het 'n paar dae terug verjaar. Mag jou jaar geseend wees. May God bless you in this coming year. May God just make his face to shine upon you, Amanda. And may you experience the favor of God. I always say, when it's your birthday, you enter into a new season. Amen. Bertha, goeiemôre, good morning. Tolly, goeiemôre, good morning. Good morning to everyone. What a privilege this morning to spend this time with you and to sit around the Word of God. Amen. So, KDN is really excited. They will have a conference in Florida. And starting tomorrow and this weekend, what a privilege just to bring the gospel. So yes, hallelujah. Gibi, also purity blessing. God bless you. Thank you for joining us this morning in our word. And God is really doing something great. Pastor Saki, goeiemôre, good morning. May your trip to Johannesburg and wherever you will going. I know you also will come for a conference, but you also go to your mom. We also pray for your mom. But may God bless you, Pastor. Have a safe journey. Just know that God is with you. Mora, my ma. Good morning, good morning. All the way there in Kimberley. Good morning to everyone. Are you excited? I mean, we should be excited. Doesn't matter what we see. Doesn't matter what we face. I mean, Psalm 23 is just this psalm that says, you know, the Lord is my shepherd. Why should I worry? Why should I allow the lies of the devil? So yes, I really want to encourage you today to trust in and believe and lean upon God. Trust in God. I mean, this is not my word today. I'm excited about this word. I will minister to you. But I just want to encourage you. Don't allow the darkness to tell you, regarding what God can and cannot do. I just think we allow so many of these voices to speak into our lives. But let me pray and we start today. Amen. Father, as we become quiet in our spirit, we just surrender. We say, Lord, here we are, your children. Just touch us, Lord. Just touch us, Lord. I thank you, Lord Jesus, for who you are. I thank you. I thank you, Lord, that today this word will just touch the hearts and the minds of people. Lord, that you will build up. Lord, that you will edify. But most of all, Father, let your presence, your glory will come upon everyone and will be manifesting on everyone. Lord, also for today's word, touch us. I just pray today, Lord, that the word will speak in our hearts, knowing, Father, the wisdom and have understanding. We honor you right now. I pray for everyone. I pray for Pastor Saki, for his mom, Lord. Just touch her right where she is, Lord. Just touch her. Let your presence manifest. Father, we speak healing. We speak restoration. We release the word of God over and we say, be healed in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Sophia, goeiemôre. Good morning. Amanda, I don't know if you're still online. Maybe you can just send me a thumb. I believe God is speaking to me to give you a prophetic word. But I don't know if you're online, so just tell me you're online, then I will tell you what I just experienced God wants to say. And I just believe God wants to speak into your life. So yes, give me a thumb up. Once you do that, I know that you're online. I don't know if you already gone offline. So yes, but once that, I will then stop and I will speak to you. Lapis, goeiemôre. Good morning, good morning. Yes, Sophia, good morning to everyone. Thank you for watching. Thank you for participating. Thank you for praying for me. Thank you. Okay, Amanda, praise God. This is what God is showing me. And the thing is, I don't know if you currently are going through some stuff, but what I'm just seeing, I see this piece of wood And it's like being a bird being carved out in this piece of wood, but the wood is still so. It's like in this middle piece, I see this bird. It looks like a hummingbird that's been, being carved out, and it's, I see like a bluish color. And this is what I experienced in my spirit. God wants to tell you, and I believe, you know, the Jonathan. Good morning, Selamat Siang. So this is what I experienced. God wants to say to you. He's busy carving out a specific thing in your life. Initially, there's something that starts to happen in your life, in your heart, you want to do for God, and you just cannot get your mind to it. You just cannot get the grip. God, what you want to do? God, I'm not sure. And this is this piece of wood before the carving actually started. But God has since, you know, maybe the last 2 months, actually maybe the beginning of this year, God has been starting to carving out this bird. God is busy carving out the specific thing in your life. And it is start to making sense. Over the last 2 months, you start to getting glimpses of something you experience in your heart. It start to making a picture. And you start to see it, but there's a specific direction that God wants to take you. What I just experienced this morning from God is God said, I am not yet complete. I am not yet finished with what I'm busy in your life. Because I'm still, there's edges and there's coloring and stuff that needs to be happened. But soon God said, you will have the bigger picture. God said, everything that you've been asking and praying for will suddenly come together in one picture. And you will know, but this is it. This is your season. And this is exactly, I don't know if currently you between minds, God, what you want me to do. It's like, I just experienced, you know, you're not sure. But God says, soon all of these things will come together. You will have a clear picture and you will know, but this is the way and this is what God wants to do. So God said, just be patient. Soon you will see He's the fullness of what God's plan is for your life. So God bless you. Pastor Marius, goeiemôre, good morning, good morning. If I've not yet greeted you, may God bless you today. Amen. May God just touch you. Pastor Marius, I really pray for you and for all the people for the conference that will start tomorrow. May God just shower you with His blessings. May God just touch you. May God just bring His glory upon this conference. And may many people be touched by signs, wonders, and miracles, but mostly by the presence of God. May God bless you. We pray for you. But this morning, I'm speaking about love increases and releases the anointing. There's this thing. Amen. Amanda, praise God for that. Give God all the glory. I just say, Amanda, I really believe it's something exciting. I believe the hummingbird, it's something small, but you know, it will come into existence. It will come into fullness. And the color, it's a glory. It's like God will bring you in a higher dimension, Amanda. So praise God for that. So when love increases, it releases more of the anointing. And we need to know and understand this morning that there's a direct link between the anointing and love. So let's first focus a bit on the anointing. We are anointed for a purpose. In 1 John chapter 3, 8, it says, so let's find out what is the purpose of the anointing. Ina, goeiemôre, good morning. It says, but the one who indulges in a sinful life is of the devil, because the devil has been sinning from the beginning. The reason the Son of God was revealed was to undo and destroy the works of the devil. So the purpose of the Son of God being manifest was to destroy the works of the devil. Now let's look for a moment, what is this work? I mean, John 10:10 says the devil came to steal, kill, steal and destroy. It came through lie and deceive and will lead people astray. Bring confusion, torture and torment, pervert, hinder, oppose and restrict, make hopeless, depression, discourage, stress, unbelief, make afraid, cause failure, poverty or sickness, bring abuse, hatred, suspicion, selfishness and judgment. So many of these things is what the believer are being challenged with in their lives. That's the work of the devil. Amen. So Jesus as the anointing. Pastor Frikkie, goeiemôre, God bless you. I really pray for that project of the church in Lesotho. May God just bless you. May God just release the finance necessary. And may God just you know, supernaturally do something in that place, in that area. Praise God for that. So Jesus is the anointing and the anointed one. Now this already must tell you something. So the anointing is the presence of actually the anointed one. And he came to destroy these works of the devil. Therefore the anointing comes in our lives to destroy the works of the devil. Now, sorry for that. Now let's pause for a moment. The anointing comes in our lives to destroy the works of the devil. Most of the time we focus there. We focus on maybe the enemy coming. But many times of the things are still residing in our soul dimension. You know, the old nature or the flesh. So the anointing coming upon your life is also there to destroy the works of the devil that he's trying to hinder you in your own life. So, I mean, Jesus Christ or Jesus the Christ means Jesus the Anointed One. I mean, the single title Christos in Greek is sometimes used to signify the one who by his Holy Spirit and power indwells believers and mold their characters to the conformity to his likeness. In 1 John chapter 2:20, it says, "But the Holy One has anointed you, and you are all know the truth." So when the anointing comes, there's a revelation of truth that will come to you. What is that truth? That Jesus did die and did bring you in a place of victory. The truth in Revelation 11 verse 10, that says we have the victory through the blood of Jesus and through our testimony. So it's the truth that comes alive in you, and then you start speaking against the lies of the devil. 1 John chapter 2:27. "But the wonderful anointing you have received from God is so much greater than their deception and now lives in you." So, and I'm speaking especially now maybe people that are attacked by the enemy, especially with depression. I mean, what is depression? The devil tell you cannot handle it. You don't have the faith. You cannot stand strong. All these lies. But it's the anointing that break the yoke. You know, tell the devil to go. So we see here that in 1 John 2:27, "But the wonderful anointing you have received from God is so much greater than their deception and now lives in you." So whatever deception is in your life, the anointing is greater than that. There's no need for anyone to keep teaching you this. Anointing teaches you all that you need to know, for it will lead you into the truth, not counterfeit. So just as the anointing has taught you, remain in him. That's in the Passion Translation. So the anointing abides in us and teaches us. The same thing that came on Jesus and live in him is the same thing that live in you and me today. And I want you just to think for a moment. It comes from, you know, it comes for the same purpose. And what is that purpose? Why we have the anointing? To destroy the works of the devil. So it's when the anointing come of you and you come and you pray for somebody that's sick. Why do you pray for the sick? To destroy the works of the devil in that person. When you pray for somebody that's broken or whatever the thing they struggle, the anointing coming there to destroy whatever the devil tries to do. So to destroy them first in our own lives. So the anointing first will start to work in your life. Amen. And then, you know, to work through us to destroy the works of the devil in other people's lives. Amen. Acts chapter 10:38. Now listen to the scripture. "See how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth." Now we can say, "See how God anointed you and me with the Holy Spirit and with power." Now listen, what did Jesus do with the anointing? "Who went about doing good." Now remember that. He went about to do good. That's the first thing we need to understand. In particular, curing all who were oppressed of the devil. My question today, do you have the anointing? Are the anointer Jesus himself living on the inside? If that is true, it is the Holy Spirit and power, the same thing that Jesus had, that wants to work through you. So whatever you are facing, let the Holy Spirit and the power, the anointing, destroy that yoke, destroy that works of the devil, but also to the outside. I say the power of God, the anointing came on Jesus and dwelt in him to enable him to do good. So why do we pray for the anointing? Why do we stir the gifts on the inside? Why we have the anointing? Well, to enable us to do good. So the first thing is to destroy the works of the devil. But secondly, the anointing is to do good to other people and thereby destroy the works of the devil in other people. We need to clearly see that it is doing good to destroy the works of the devil. And many times we are attacked by people and then we stop doing good. We just stop it. But the anointing is there so to keep on doing good. Consistently doing right destroys the result of previous wrongdoings. So the anointing does us good and destroys the works of the devil in us. Listen to Romans chapter 8 verse 10. But if Christ the anointing live in you, but, so it says, if we agree that the anointing of Jesus Christ, the power and the Holy Spirit lives in you, then although your natural body is dead by reason of sin and guilt, and the Spirit is alive because of the righteousness that he imputes to you. Amen. Verse 11. And if that same Spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells in you, it shall quicken your mortal body. The good thing in you overcomes the bad thing that has come against you. And especially people that's DID or ADD, or not DID, but ADD, or are being in this oppression, by their depression. I want to tell you, it's the anointing that destroys that yoke. It's the presence, it's the understanding. I don't seek out there the victory. The victory is in the anointing of Christ Jesus through his Holy Spirit and power in me that destroyed the legal right and the yoke and the works of the devil in my life. It says the good thing in you that overcomes the bad thing that has come against you. So what is in you is greater than anything on or come against you. In 1 John chapter 4:4, it says, greater is he that is in you than he is in the world. The thing is that, just this, we allow our minds to tell us the fight is ours. The fight is not yours. It's the anointing, the presence of the Holy Spirit and the power of God that manifest and get rid of these things in your life. Gerard, goeiemorgen. Galatians 2:20, it is no longer I who live. Well, that by itself says so much. You are dead. It's Christ Jesus, the anointing and the anointed one that lives in you. You see, the thing is, if there is much of I, it is the anointing that delivers me from I. I want this, I see this, and I say this, and I doubt, and I this. It's the anointing that delivers me from the I. I represents the independence and selfishness, two of the yokes that must be broken. So what does I do? I mean, you depend on yourself and it's being selfish. And guess what? That is opposite of what the anointing do. But the anointing overcomes those things. I said, remember, the anointing is the thing that destroyed the yoke. If I follow the anointing and it leads me in a love walk that renders me free from selfish and self-centeredness. Now, this is the love. What is love? John 3:16. Because God so loved the world that he's given his only begotten son. Meaning a sacrifice is the thing that reproduces or actually shows the love of God. Amen. So let's talk about, because I've said that love releases the anointing. Galatians 4:19. My little children, for whom I am again suffering birth pangs until Christ, the anointed and the anointed one, is completely and permanently formed, molded within you. Christ, the anointing, is being permanently filled with inside of you. Amen. So Paul knew the importance of the anointing being brought into full manifestation. Work with the anointing, increase it, release it, respect it, flow it, and it will then come to full manifestation in you. There's actually no excuse for us not to walk in victory. There's actually no excuse for us to walk in limitations. Jesus never had any limitations. Because he walked in the anointing, and that anointing is the fullness of the Holy Spirit and in the power of God. Amen. And now it's in us. So why do we limit what the Holy Spirit wants to give us? Why do we allow to come under the yoke of the enemy? Whereas we have everything just to rise up and to deal with this thing. Let the anointing overcome whatever yoke the enemy wants to place on your life. Ephesians 3:17. Make Christ the anointing and the anointed one through your faith. Actually, dwell, settle down, abide, make his permanent home in your heart. Listen, a permanent home. God is not going out and in and going out. But it's through your faith that he comes to dwell in your heart. It's through your faith. What is your faith? It's what I believe. Not what I see, but what I believe. He says, may you be rooted deep in love and founded securely on love. So let's just see Ephesians 3:17 again in the Passion Translation in context. Listen what it says. It says, make Christ the anointed, the anointing and the anointed one, through your faith, actually dwell, settle down, abide, make his permanent residence in your hearts. May you be rooted deep in love and founded securely on love. So we see now that the anointing through your faith dwells in you, but it's rooted in love. The origin, the foundation of the anointing comes from love. I say the anointing will deliver us from the bondage of insecurity and get us rooted deep in the love of God. So, in 1 John 4:18, I want you to see in context what I'm trying to tell you. Listen what it says. Love never brings fear. Now, let me stop. If love is the thing that you are rooted in, coming back to the previous scripture, it says Ephesians 3:17, may Christ through your faith actually make your heart his permanent home. May you be rooted in love and found securely on love. Now, listen what it says now in 1 John 4:18. Love never brings fear. So, what is fear? So, the moment your foundation that you are rooted in, where the anointing operates from, if there's fear and there's no love, you limit the anointing, the power of God as well as the Holy Spirit in that condition, and the enemy will overcome you. But if it's rooted, what love? Listen what 1 John 4:18 says. Love never brings fear. Knowing that God loves you. Knowing you don't need to stress. You don't need to worry about the things. You are founded in the love that Jesus loves you. You give your heart, you die, and you now live in him. And the foundation is whatever I face. Nothing is impossible because greater is he that's in me, dwelling in me, the anointing, the same anointing, the power and the Holy Spirit that dwelt in Jesus lives now in me. So from that foundation, I live a life to the outside. And that's why it says, love never brings fear, 1 John 4:18. For fear is always related to punishment. So the moment you allow fear, you allow the yoke of the devil to come upon you through stress and all of these things. But listen what he says. But love's perfection drives the fear of punishment from our hearts. Whoever walks constantly afraid of punishment has not reached love's perfection. What it says, if you continually walk, you know, with unbelief, you walk with, I don't know if God loves me. I don't know. You don't have the foundation, and the anointing is not rooted then in your life. Because love is the thing that needs to increase for the anointing to be released. I want you to see that. So if you allow fear, you take away the foundation of the anointing, and the fear will overshadow the power of the Holy Spirit and the power. The fear will come into a place and you close the door of the anointing to bring a breakthrough in your life. And that's why it says, I want to go back to Ephesians 3:17. Why faith is so important. May Christ, the anointing and the anointed, through your faith, actually dwell, settle down and make your you his permanent home. In your hearts. May you be rooted deep in love and found securely on that love. That's when the anointing will be released. So perfect love casts out fear. Love activates the anointing to drive out the devil. So if you have fear, you don't have the thing that activates the anointing that will drive out the devil. That's why people are so much people are in depression. Because it says, let me go back. Love never brings fear. But if there's fear, it always related to punishment. Now, what is the punishment? Is what the devil brings to you is the feelings you're feeling of lost and hope and worthlessness. But it's the love. We overcome the devil. Let me just go back to what I want to say. Love activates the anointing to drive out the devil. So if you have fear and your foundation is not love, you cannot activate the Holy Spirit and the power which is the anointing to drive out the things in your own life, even, you know, by doing good to other people. So we overcome the evil with good. So love and good is actually the things from where the anointing manifests. Amen. So Romans 12:21. Hello, my darling wife. Do not be overcome by the evil. He says, listen, don't allow the lies and deceit and all the works of the devil. Don't be overcome by that. But overcome that by doing good. So we see one thing. If you want to get in victory, start doing good to other people. It's a life principle. Overcome evil with good. But what does the world says? Well, an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. But God said, no, no, no. Turn the other cheek. Through your doing good, what happens? You will overcome the enemy. And I want to show you something further. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 15, see that no one repays anyone evil for evil, but always seek to do good to one another and to everyone. So, out of love, it's the love that helps you to do good. But what does it do? The love that helps you to do good makes you to overcome the evil. You see, many times we just want to pray against the evil. We just want to declare over the evil. But the evil can only live if the foundation is love. And out of that love, by doing good. That's how we overcome the devil. Listen, never return evil for evil. But aim to show kindness and seek to do good to one another. Especially in the body of Christ. Listen what Luke 2:14 says. Glory to God in the highest realms of heaven. For there is peace, a good hope given to the sons of men. So, there are good hope given to the sons of man. And the word good is God's will towards men. God, Jesus Christ, the anointing has arrived to bring that good into your life. And by doing so, he will destroy the works of the devil. I want you to see something. God is a God of principle. If we follow the principles, we will live in that place of victory. We will live in that place of authority. But if we have the foundation anchored that our love, we understand who we are in Christ Jesus, being founded in that love and by doing good. I mean, let's go back to Acts chapter 10 verse 38. Just see what it says, Acts chapter 10 38. I will not go back, I will just quote it. It says, and Jesus went through the whole country doing good. And in that, he destroyed everyone that was under the oppression of a spirit of sickness. So, what is his testimony? He is doing good, and in doing good, he sees the victory overcoming the devil in the lives of people being healed. I want you to see that. But it's rooted in the love of the Father that he has. And now what the Father gave him, he started doing it to the outside, doing good. And as he went through, wherever he went, he did good. And as he did good, he saw the manifestation of the supernatural happen and come upon people. The blind see, the deaf hear, the lame walk, the deaf arise. Why? Because the main thing of the anointing is to doing good, is being the hands and feet of Jesus Christ out there and positioned you for the anointing to touch people and bring healing. But it first started in your life. That's why If you have feared, the love did not yet come to that fullness. And God wants us to have that fullness. Then by your faith, Mariki, hello. Salamat siang. So the love makes that, you know, we have the foundation, and by doing good, pushed by the love of God, we will overcome the devil. So Matthew 5:16 actually, get out in the world and do good deeds so that people will see them and glorify your Father in heaven. When Jesus comes, our lives and the anointing destroy the yoke of selfishness. And we begin to do good, walk in love, and desire to be a blessing. And you know what? When you start doing it, the world starts to take notice. Especially people maybe that previously know you. Are you living a life in a foundation that I know Jesus loves me? In that foundation, rooted in that. Because if that from that foundation, the anointing, the Holy Spirit, and the power is ready to break the yoke and to break the works of the devil. How do we do that? So once we start walking in that, what happens? It starts to touch people. Jesus was drawn. I mean, the people was drawn to him. Why? Because he was doing good. And out of that, the anointing could not wait to touch them. That's why even the blood, you know, the woman with the blood issue, she just said, I need to touch him. Because the foundation, love, it, as love increases, it also releases the anointing. That's why when you pray for somebody, pray, come with the love of Christ. Not by judgment or think, oh, well, you have sinned. Maybe you are paying a price because of the sin in your life. That's why people will not get healed. But coming with the compassion. I mean, it's so amazing when Jesus came and Lazarus already died and Martha and Maria cried. And the people said the following. They see the compassion, how much he loved Lazarus. They see that. Now listen in context what we're saying. Jesus, you know, that love for his friend that died, that love is the foundation from where the anointing can operate. And by knowing that from that love, if I can do good, I can say, Lazarus, come out, and he will come out. Because I'm in line through to release the anointing by the love of the Father, the love for Lazarus, and by the compassion I have. I mean, he didn't wait anything. Ellen, hello. Salamat siang. He didn't wait. He just said, show me the grave, roll back the stone. Let me show you the anointing manifest. The love of the Father for Lazarus and for you. Let it just flow. That's why love is such an important thing. The foundation from where it releases the anointing. But one of the major things is, why do we need to release the anointing? Is to do good. And you know what? When it comes to you, God wants to do good in your life. He wants to start with you. He wants to make you free. He wants to bring you into that dimension of being set free of the works and the yoke of the devil. Amen. So being good to those who mistreat you builds your character. Amen. I want to complete. In Luke chapter 6 verse 35, listen what it says. But love your enemies and continue to treat them well. When you lend money, don't despair if you are never paid back, for it's not lost. You will receive a rich reward, and you will be known as true children of the Most High God, having His same nature. Hallelujah. Having His same nature. This is in a Passion Translation. For your Father is famous for His kindness to heal even the thankless and cruel. How much more should we not operate in the anointing? But it's only being found in if you are rooted in love and being kind. This is just an amazing translation in the Passion, Luke 6:35. For your Father is famous for His kindness to heal even the thankless and cruel. Are we that kind to people? You know, today it's so sad if you look at the body of Christ, how people eating each other and they judge each other and they speak ill to. This is not even the thankless. This is not even the ones that don't know Christ. We cannot even have this love for one another, but we want to see the signs, wonders, and miracles. We want to see the anointing touch the people, but we are not rooted in love. And even we have the faith, but our foundation of love is not good. That's why the anointing cannot be released. But it's the heart to doing good that proves your foundation of love is secure. And it's by doing good you show this, the kindness that the Father is famous to. And now it's start to release the anointing. And people getting healed. People getting... Because why? They are drawn by the goodness of God. So that's so important why it says, love your enemies and be kind in doing good. And lend, expecting and hoping for nothing in return. You see, the moment we want something in return, guess what? We close the process how the anointing works. The anointing platform is in love. And that love pushes you to doing good. Doesn't matter who the person is. And when you start doing that, you are positioned for the anointing to start touching people. And it will increase and people will look at you and say, wow. Wow. I see the kindness of God. But the moment you are not kind anymore, what happens? You move away from the foundation of the love of Christ Jesus in your life. And what happens? The anointing cannot flow because it's love that activates the anointing. And it's the love that makes you to position by doing good, brings you to the place where you release the anointing. And you will see the manifestation of God's healing power. I want you to see that today. Now listen what I want to say. So I said, love your enemies and be kind and do good. And lend, expecting and hoping for nothing in return. But consider nothing as lost and despairing of no one. And then your recompense will be great. Now Pastor Marius said, this is the year of recompense. I want to add something to that. We need to get back to the basic. When will the recompense will start, the reward start to happen? If we come back to love. Unconditional love. And then from that platform, out of that love, what Christ did for us, we start doing good. And as we start doing good, the anointing just start to flow. It just start to flow, touching people. And then out of that, we see how God reward, recompense, just start to happen in your own life. Amen. I say that love affects the anointing. Ephesians 4:29, I'm nearly done. And never let ugly or hateful words come from your mouth. But instead, let your words become beautiful gifts that encourage others. Do this by speaking words of grace to help them. The Holy Spirit of God has sealed you in Christ Jesus until you experience your full salvation. What is that full salvation? To come in the fullness of love by doing good, the character, the kindness of the Father, showing through Jesus, now showing through you and me, position us for the anointing to manifest. So never grieve the Holy Spirit of God and take for granted His holy influence in your life. Lay aside bitter words, temper tantrums, revenge, profanity, and insults. So what do we see? Love needs to increase that releases the anointing. Hallelujah. Praise God. God is a God of principle. If there's no love, there's fear. And as long as there's fear, the anointing cannot be activated. The anointing cannot do good to other people. It's by coming into the fullness, knowing that God loves you. Doesn't matter what happened, God loves you. And by out of that position, experiencing His love, subdue the, you know, the works of the devil, the fear and all of those things. What now start to happen? That love pushes you to start doing good to other people, but it starts in your own life and start dealing with the works of the devil in your own life. And as that happens, as you start doing good out of that love, because the character is, I want to do good to the outside. I want to pray for you. I want to release. I want to declare of you. What then happens? As you do good, you activate. The love activates through doing good, activates the anointing. What is the anointing? The Holy Spirit and the power of God. And that's why we need to get back to the basics. Because we eat each other with words, we bitter and we negative. How can the anointing being released if we don't even do good to our own brother? And that's why if you read in 1 John chapter 4, just I think verse 21, it says, how you can say you love God but you hate your brother? What does he say? How can you move in the anointing if there's hatred and bitterness against your brother? How you can say that the outside presence that people see you They see the bitterness, but they do not see the love of Christ. How the anointing can move from a vessel of bitterness and all of that cannot. And you know, everybody now just eat each other and they judge this ministry and this pastor and everybody's just shouting. But you know what is the sad part? The devil is laughing. Because you know, as long as we do that, we cannot flow in the anointing. Because doing good and the foundation of love being rooted in our hearts by our faith, knowing that we know who God is, and out of that doing good, then the anointing will start to manifest. But if there's bitterness, the works of the devil on inside is because you lack love. It's because you and your mindset, you allowed to give away things to the devil. But God said, you know what? What is the proof of the kindness of the Father? When you do good, you can only do good if you have the love, the pure love, knowing that God loves you. And when you have that, you will do good. And then the anointing will just start to flow, just start to flow. You will speak the word and people will be healed. People will be set free. I would like to pray for you today. I believe God, this is an in-season word. And especially for a month laying ahead, April. Tomorrow is the fourth month. My question is, God has given you an unction, has given you a word on the 1st of January or through January. Are you pursuing that word? Are you still positive, waiting for what God is about to do for the outpour? God is showing us how the anointing can start to flow. And as this last day, God is saying for this month also, if you want to flow in the anointing, get back by loving Him. Get rid of fear, anxiety, and all of these things. And in that love, you will start doing good. Start looking for places to do good. And then the anointing will start to flow just by itself. Why? Because that will show the kindness of God. That will show people who God is. Not by what you're preaching, by what you're doing. Because now you've come into victory over the works of the devil in your own life. That worthlessness, selfishness, etc. That eyes. I would like to pray for you today. Father, I thank you this morning for this word. Lord, teach us. Teach us your ways. We all want to flow in the anointing, but it's one thing we see that love activates the anointing. As love grows, the anointing grows. But out of love, it's the doing good, is the manifestation of the kindness of the Father that's been seen on the believers. And it's that kindness, Lord, that things that we do, that suddenly the anointing just start to flow. Word of wisdom, word of knowledge, healing, Father, works of breakthrough. Suddenly many things in our lives just change and start to change to the outside. We honor you right now. Father, let the word fall in our hearts today. Just touch us, Lord. Bring us back into your glory. Let's come to Acts chapter 10 verse 38, that Jesus went throughout the whole country doing good. Let it also be said of us, we're doing good. Doesn't matter what we have, because the foundation is love. That love is Jesus Christ. Doing good. And he broke every yoke of the devil. Everybody that was oppressed by a spirit of sickness, he just broke them and he set them free. The anointing can only flow when it's been activated by love. But doing good, Lord, is the positioning where it starts to manifest. Let us know and let us understand. Bless everyone, Lord. I speak your life and blessing over this month, Lord. I pray that you will bring everybody into greatness. I pray for an outpour, a fresh anointing in everyone. I pray, Lord, that we will rise up. We will not allow fear, and that, Lord, in that authority, we will start doing good, showing the kindness of the Father to this lost world, but especially to our brothers and sisters. Father, bless them, cover them. I just release a breakthrough in everyone's life. May the anointing break yokes right now, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, be honored and glorified. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Lapis, yes, that's true. Lydia. Yes, amen, hallelujah, praise God. I just want to encourage you, may you have a blessed day. May your month coming, starting tomorrow, be a month of blessing. May God just touch you. May you experience His fullness. Share this with somebody. Somebody needs to hear that. And somebody needs to be set free. And this is the way. This is how God will set them free, breaking the yokes of the devil, the strongholds in their own lives, by loving Christ and releasing the good. May God bless you. Thank you for watching. I pray for you. Thank you for your comments. God bless you.